Hi ladies, how are you doing? This is me, TT. I'm out here today continuing my spiritual boot camp. I am here at this park. I forgot the name of the park. It's Mackenzie River in front of me. I'll put the name of the park at the bottom. But it's Mackenzie River in front of me. I'm in Oregon. I just crossed that bridge over here, over there to come to this park. Isn't this beautiful? Look at this river. It's just so nice and cozy over here. Oh, I could just sit here for hours. It's just so nice and peaceful. And it's about, 6 o'clock in the evening. So, yes, I'm doing another spiritual boot camp to draw closer to the Lord because I need strength from Him. We all do. And so, and at times we need it more than others, you know, when we're going through things. And it's been a trying time for all of us. The last 3 months and the last 12 months since 2020, the beginning of 2020, it's been a rough time for many of us. And so, you know, I heard a very good sermon today. I think it was today. No, yesterday and today. And today. Two preachers in the Lord's church. And man, their sermon was exactly what I need to be reminded of. It was things I knew, but you know, we need to be reminded of the Word of God. This is why God gave us the Holy Bible, because we need to be reminded of things of the Word of God and how God is there for us and how He's going to help us. We need to be reminded. And so I was reminded, you know, that we're going through trials. We're going to go through trials. God allows trials. And sometimes extremely difficult trials, such as what happened to Job, to happen to us, for us to go through these things. And the purpose is not to harm us, it's to make us stronger and to depend on God and to seek Him wholeheartedly. To seek Him wholeheartedly, not half-heartedly, but wholeheartedly. That's the purpose of the trials. And I have been asking God to help me draw closer to Him, and He did. It didn't happen the way I wanted it to happen, but it happened. And it wasn't easy to accept at first, you know. Like I was telling some of you, I hurt my foot. I really broke my foot. Can't believe it. But it's healed, and but I'm still in rehab and everything, and it's taking a while. But it's like, to me, it's like that's the last thing I needed right now. But spiritually, it was what I needed. This was what I needed. And so that's what I'm going through right now. We're all going through something. But I'm okay. I'm okay. I'm getting better. And God has revealed things to me, or reminded, mostly just reminded me of things that's written in the Holy Bible and through preachers and teaching of the Word, hearing of the Word. Faith come by hearing, Romans 10:17. And so, you know, that's what I need to be reminded of. You know, that God still loves me. He has not given up on me. He allowed the trial because I needed to draw closer to Him. And I'm going to come out better, stronger. Still has a plan for me. God still has a plan for me, for you, whatever you're going through. God has a plan for us. And so even through the trials, and that's what the trial is for. Satan uses the trial, as I just heard a preacher say, a very good sermon. Satan uses the trial, try to use the trial to make us doubt God and His goodness. And so we do well to remember during the trial that God still loves us. He's what is in the book of Genesis, I think 50, verse 20, what you meant for harm, God meant for my good. You know, and so that's what we could say for Satan and his workers, that, you know, what you meant for my harm, God meant for my good. Romans 8:28, God gonna turn this into my favor. And so that's where I am right now. And you may be there too. Many of us are, you know, it's what's going on in the world, all around the world today. And it's affecting the church. I just learned that one of my sisters in Christ that helped me and my husband get our 501c3 for our congregation / outreach center. She passed. She had COVID. She died of COVID in March. Her and her daughter. And her daughter was, I believe, only in her 50s. And they both died of COVID within 30 days of each other. And so that was really heartbreaking for me to hear, you know. And Satan, he just uses everything, you know, to try to pull us down, break us down. And that broke my heart. I couldn't even sleep when I heard about her death. It was hard for me to sleep. I tossed and turned because she was a very dear sister to me. And I was going to miss her. Her name is Ethel Graham. And she was a blessing. She lived in Vegas where I live for about 5 years, something like that, give or take. And we used to go on walks together, and I used to help counsel her, so she said she needed my services. But she was a beautiful lady, and she just brought joy to everybody. She loved buying gifts for people. It would be small gifts, but just the thought that someone would be thinking of you and buy you a gift. Everyone just loved her when she was here in Vegas. I'm sure her family as well loved her, but when she lived here in Vegas where I live. So anyway, so Satan's always trying to break us down, you know, but when we had a right attitude, outlook, or perspective, a godly perspective, and see everything from a spiritual point of view, we can get through, we can triumph over our trials that are sure to come. The Bible says the righteous person, like Job, has many trials, but God will deliver them from all of them. Not some, all. So whatever you're going through, God going to deliver you from all of it. Okay? That's the word of God. That's his promise. To deliver us, to see us through, Hebrews 13:5, and to turn it into our favor, if nothing else. But God will see us through. God going to see you through. God's going to see you through your trial. He's going to see me through, and he saw me through this. I'm at the end of this trial, and it's been a long one. And so, yeah, I broke my foot in June last year, and I'm still going to rehab. So, but it's all good though. So God has something great on the other side for me and for you. So hang in there. Don't give up. Whatever you do, don't give up. Okay? Don't give up. I love you ladies. You know I'm here for you. I'm here for you. God works through people. Satan works through people too, but we don't want to be used by the devil. We want to be a vessel to be used by God. And so I'm here for you. And so I just love you all, and I just hope that this has been a blessing to you. And that river, look how beautiful it is, Mackenzie River. It's just so pretty. Look at that water just flowing. And it's flowing north. That's different. I thought all rivers float south. I guess not. I don't know, but maybe I'm thinking it's north. Maybe it's not. But anyway, isn't this just so beautiful up here, and it's so peaceful and quiet. It's like a little campsite picnic area or something. I think it's RV park /2/park or whatever. Okay, ladies. So I just want to tell you that I love you. Love you, ladies. Stay in touch. God bless you. You can please click like and subscribe. Let me know so I can continue to post these encouraging videos. And I'm also putting up some songs. I will be putting up some songs by my husband. He's a gifted musician. And I'll be putting up some spiritual songs. He's very good at playing the piano. And I'm going to be putting those up. He hasn't played in a while, so he's warming up. But I'm putting those up with scripture. You'll see one up coming up. You'll see them up there. I'm going to be posting scripture. And so it's something that you can just sit back in your home on a computer or on your YouTube channel, on the television, and listen to beautiful music with scriptures to help you draw closer to God and praise God and encourage your faith and everything. I'm gonna be putting that up. So I want to do different things on my channel. Okay, ladies. And so ladies, I'm here for you. Like I said, you know where I'm at. You know how to reach me. All the information is on the screen. God bless you and keep you. Chat with you later. Bye-bye.